because this discussion is only for persons who have an interest. I mean, let's be candid here and let us be straight up and honest. Not everybody is interested. So if you're not interested in having spontaneous sex or being attractive to your partner, then this conversation is just not for you. Yes, I do, Mr. Johnson. Right? So, for those who don't know me, I'm Sandra Samuels, CEO of Totally Male. And I have been in the grooming business, which is what this is about, really. I've been in the grooming business for 25 years of men, grooming of men. And when I posted this talk, a lot of persons started to talk about what women are doing in the household. But what about men? Are we having a discussion? Are we demanding from our men to be sexy for us? Are we demanding of our men to be clean for us? You know, I like to liken sex or being appealing. Let's say liken sex, liken being attractive to the opposite sex to finding a plate of food appealing to eat. Because in a sexual world, from your head to your toes should be appealing, ready, depending on what your partner enjoys. From your head to your toe, you need to be clean. Clean, clean, like Jesus' police record. Absolutely. That goes for men and that goes for women. Now, based on what you get is based on what you accept from your partner. You teach people how to treat. You and you also teach people what you want and what is it that you want. You have to be specific. So we're gonna have, I'd like some questions and some input from you with regards to or you know, even say a little bit about what your experience is in the COVID 19 situation, since I don't have any, right? What has it been so far? You know, is your significant other even making an effort to be attractive for you? Is he wearing the same underpants from Monday to Sunday? Is she wearing the same, whether it's a house coat or a nightgown or a teddy or whatever it is, for the entire week? Is that what you want? Did you tell her what you want? And we're not talking, people, we're not necessarily talking about sex. We're talking about occupying the same space with your significant other and also inviting to treat if you want, and also having a discussion about your likes and dislikes, because this time, as it is unprecedented, we have never had so much time to sit down and have time to talk, to catch up, to be there for, to be there with our significant other. So what has been your experiences, and you know, what is it that you'd like your man to know? This is for the woman. You know, what would you like your man to know about what you want from him? You know, men demand certain things from a woman. Is your body ready? to receive it. Same thing with women. You demand certain things from a man. Is your body ready to receive it spontaneously whilst you're both at home? These are some of the questions, some of the discussions that we would like to have. So, who wants to be up first? Anybody wants to share with the group about their experience in this shut-in period? Anybody? A man, be brave. Adrian. For someone who has been a customer of Totally Male for a long time and knows the value of grooming, would you say it has aided you in being more attractive to the opposite sex, to your significant other? It's been surprisingly good, yes? This is just from Mr. Johnson. The thing is, even when I was preparing for this talk, I wondered, and somebody may can say something, I wondered when was the last time you did an update. You know, computers need to be upgraded. Books are, you get new revised editions. You are married 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. When was the last time you checked? Hi, Adrian. When was the last time you checked as to, you know, what makes your man or what makes your woman excited when you enter a room? You know, when last have you, you know, done something special, something different? We are always busy. Now you have the time. There's no more excuse. Let us know. Tell us, what has your COVID-19 experience? Don't be shy. It's after 9. And this is a grown folk conversation. Grown folk. We're talking about grooming. What about grooming each other? You shave me, I shave you. As if you like shaving. Some people like hair. I don't like hair, but some people do. When was the last time you told your lover what you like about his body or her body? Hi, Michelle. Thanks for joining the conversation. But I need some system. Right, you need a system update every week, reboot, recheck. Yes, but let us be honest. Are we having this discussion with our significant other as to what we like? But even if you're single, Adrian, I'm sure you are active. Okay, sometimes you don't have to check. You have lots of time to read and try new things, new touch, new spot. Okay, you have lots of time. The person wants. Everybody have a different love language. Everybody have a different sex language. But how do you know what parts of your body is most appreciated by your significant other? Is it clean and ready? Suppose your significant other has a foot fetish. Do you even know? Or they might have to step outside to get what their heart's desire is. I never shy to share what I like. I'm vocal. Excellent. And you also ask her what she wants as well, right? Am I correct? Anil? Yes? I'm assuming so, because I know you're a vocal man. Yes, Shireen, you're saying something. I don't want any smiley faces. I don't want any waves. I want a discussion. Absolutely. I find, okay, so many times I have to have these discussions with my men. When I say my men, I'm talking about my customers now, right? I have these discussions, and we talk about grooming, and we talk about sex, Okay, Jan, one other scent I request to be. Oh, Jan, you want to be my live video? Okay, who's that now? I soon get to the live video, Jan. What I want to know is some of the experiences, good or bad, that this COVID-19 situation, in terms of, I've seen several vignettes around the place, several memes about persons, you know, dropping a towel and the man is still playing his game box or whatever it is. What has been your experience? This is the time to share. Persons can't get to go to, you know, their regular spa treatments. This is a time where you can shave me, I can shave you, that kind of thing. Are you taking the opportunity to share with your significant other? Yes, Jan? Yes, Jan? I want some input. I need some stories. I need some juicy stories. Lockdown means for some more busy. No. We are talking about, so say your spouse needs to get pampered. I know that, but he doesn't want to get it done. How do I go about doing that? Because some men are afraid of things happening to them. Well, first of all, Anika, did you have the conversation with him that you prefer him, whether it is shaven or you want to groom his nails? You may want to have a moment where you want to cut his nails. You think his nails are long. Men start to cook again. We go supermarket because of oh, come on. Let us keep to the topic. What you're saying, that COVID has made no difference whatsoever in terms of communication. We set up the game, man. Come on, people, let's talk. It's after 9. Let's have a serious conversation. You see, all these people I didn't know were shy. Okay, so for example, let me start. If, hypothetically speaking, if I were in a relationship right now, and I've done it before, I mean, I'm someone who likes a clean body from head to toe. I don't like hair anywhere. I like men clean. One of the reasons why I'm in the business that I am in. So that would be that wouldn't be a challenge for me to shave his pubic area or shave his chest, his back, his scrotum, everywhere. I wouldn't have a problem with that. And you don't need to be trained to do that. But my thing is, if you are going to be passionate with your significant other, male or female, and you like certain things, then you need to say so. I declined the offer to trim his hair. They don't want to spoil it. Okay, well, his hair is different because that is something that you can see. But let's say, for argument's sake, in making love, you don't like a bushy pubic area. Is that something that you would do? Take up the opportunity at this time, since he can't get to go to the spa, because we do waxing, we do shaving of the pubic area so that the band can be clean and attractive, smell good, because that's another major part of this sexual attraction. You get up in the morning, have a shower, whether you want to put on a nice cologne or just a body splash that makes you appealing. So when you walk past, whether it be the kitchen or the bedroom or just going around, going by your, you decline off, right? or you just mind your own business, these are some of the things that you can do. And remember, I said at the beginning, this is something I'm saying if you want. I'm not talking about somebody who's not interested in sex and somebody's not interested in being appealing to their significant other, because there is that situation too. I'm talking about you wanting this for yourself. Just buy a bottle of Nair. Wipe off. No. Okay. Like food, you can turn grooming into a sexual or a sensual. Let me say sensual. Sex, instead of sexual, a sensual experience. For those of you who have not done so as yet, it is, you can have a shower together, then you proceed, because you want to clean up a clean body. You don't want to start with everybody unfresh. So you have a shower, you can have a shower together and shave where's to shave and do what you have to do, and then you take it from there. But I'm not hearing anybody saying that they're taking the opportunity in this COVID-19 scenario where everybody's at home day in, day out. So that means that what that says to me now is that it's just business as usual. No, not all of us know how to shave. There is always YouTube. YouTube shows you every single thing. There are no excuses, none at all, as to why you would not be in a position to help. Yes, because a lot of our males not used to it. Yeah, but you can, it's up to you. They're having sex with you. So if this is something that you want, you know how men are. They will please you. If you say that this is something that you want, they will please you, but then you have to say so. So I'm waiting for, I'm going to invite Shireen first, and then I'm going to invite Omar to speak about his experience. Okay, okay, Shireen is... Shireen's not ready. Anybody want to share their experience? Thank you. Thank you. Yes, Omar. Omar left? Did you say something? Anil, come on, talk up the things. I need to get this conversation going. Hello? Because you seem to be the only one who is taking care of his body in this COVID-19 scenario.
I'm so tired. I'm tired of trying to fit into this game.
I thought you wanted to come in, Anil. He chickened out. Oh, God. Everybody shy? You want to come in, Jan? Oops. I'm still waiting on Anil now. Unable to join. All right. Who else? Okay. Michelle. Michelle, you have anything to say? Everybody's shy. What's the topic? Oh, Adrian, oh, you just get, Epic, go get it. Okay. The topic is sex appeal during the COVID-19 lock-in time. Are you sexy around the house? Are you cleaning up yourself? Are you making yourself appealing to your significant other? Is it something that you deem important? Does he think it's important? When was the last time that you did a self-check as to what he even finds appealing where your body is concerned? I'm not getting anybody to join me. Everybody's shy. Everybody's shy. I wonder why that is. Everybody declined. Interesting. So say so. Would you like to say something about? Okay, Sandy, I think just as you're having hesitation, this isn't something regularly discussed between. Yeah, which is a shame, you know. Some of the grooming being discussed isn't the norm for some. That's not true. It is the norm for many men. It may be the norm for persons that you know. But as I said, I'm in business 25 years, and I've been doing body shaves. I've been shaving pubic areas. I've been waxing pubic areas. I've been waxing, shaving scrotum. So somebody's doing it, right? People, men ensure, I mean, sometimes the men come in the store, they're smelling good, they're looking good, their nails have to be clean, their toenails have to be clean, and I mean, they're very meticulous about it. And they're not gay. So before we even go there, men want the woman, them to dress sexy. Yes, they do, but that's what we're talking about. We're talking about equality. Men want women to dress sexy, but are we requiring from the men to be sexy as well? Or do we accept anything? You come to bed in the same drawers or the same boxer shorts that you've been wearing the entire week because we're locked in the entire week. I mean, because there is no effort is needed. First it was 3 foot, no, it's 6 foot. What? I don't get that. You understand what I'm saying? If you want the men to be sexy, are you requiring it? Is it a requirement? I mean, they do it, whether you send them to get it done or you do it yourself. I mean, now that you're in the whole lockdown situation, we have time. But usually, we don't have time. But if this is something that you like, is it a requirement? Do you make sure that you know that this is something that make you let him know that this is something that you like? Personally, I find a hairless penis extremely attractive. Right? But some men have full bush. Is that something that you would discuss and say, oh, I don't really like that? Let me take care of it for you because he doesn't want to go to the spa. It is a requirement. If you're equally yoked, is that what you're saying? If equally yoked, then nobody should be bashful about doing what the other person wants. Because it's really open game in the bedroom or wherever, if you say what you want.
the bush must go. Absolutely. But are persons, are women telling their significant other who may be requiring oral sex that the bush is not particularly tasty or attractive or appealing, or it doesn't make them smell fresh because it holds perspiration? Is this some of the conversations that we're having? Or it's always about what the woman is wearing. If the woman is sexy, she must put on a negligee. She must put, but what are we saying about the men? We want them well groomed. Well, it's not always a requirement, because some people are here. I understand that some people like a rugged man. Some people like a hairy man. To each his own. I'm not here to judge. Everybody have their own. You used to have those conversations. Understood. Right? But what I want to know is that general for most people? Or are they afraid to let their partner know what they want? Or is it assumed that, he wants sex, so he should? My man needs to be groomed. Yeah, man. Everybody needs to be groomed. Sandy, some of the services are not natural to men. Women do their nails, hair, and that's normal to men. Yes, but the point that I'm making is, let's say it's not normal to your man, because I know many that it's normal to a totally male. Would you say to your man, or even take up a nipple, a nail clip, and say, babes, let me clip your nails, just to introduce him to him, let me clip your nails, let me moisturize your cuticles, because he's in the AC every day, the cuticles dry, his nails are overgrown. I mean, your hands are used in a sexual experience. And just like how they want to be attracted to us, we need to be attracted to them too. Because we don't just turn on just like that. It's a process. Right? And so, okay. All right. One person wants to join. Hi, Jan. Hi. Can I hear you? Okay, so what's to join the conversation, man? I heard you celebrating 35 years the other day, right? When was that? Last week?
Yeah, last Monday.
Last Monday, exactly. So last Monday, you celebrated 35 years. And I know you are still madly in love with your husband, so clearly he's doing something right. He's always well put together. He's always, both of you, always well put together. Would you? You say that there is both part. To keep up the attraction.
Naturally, yeah.
No, man, someone add more to it, man. No, man, add more to it, man.
I'm shy.
I mean, don't take it for granted. What I'm saying, no, okay, we're shy, okay. But what I'm saying, we don't just take it for granted that he understands that I find this appealing. Is it something that you would say to him, which would encourage him to do more of the same, or whatever, if he wears a cologne that he particularly enjoy? Is it something that you would say, boy, babes, this morning you really smell, out of sight? Is that something that you find that, kept you guys together, kept you, the interest going, keep the appeal going, especially in this COVID-19 situation? You don't want a body to just get up every day and just assume that, you know what I'm saying? And as a conversation I'm trying to start, because I've heard where you're gone, or afraid to tell their significant other what they want. You're gone? We're gone. I think you got cut off, Jan. Right? Gentlemen, apart from 35 years, we need the secret. Yeah, absolutely, O'Neill. I agree with you. I need to hear some more from Jan about what is the secret to keeping it fresh for. And both of them look very good. Very clean. Very together. Always well groomed. You know, but, you know, sometimes you put grooming on the back burner. Hi, Latoya. Thanks for joining. Hi, Tony. Right? We want to have this conversation, because the more I have the discussion with the men, and yes, some people are experiencing it for the first time at a mature stage in life, but this should not be, this should be the norm, don't you think? Join the conversation, man. Shouldn't this be the norm that men know, instead of it being the exception, and then they're labeled as metrosexual, you know, and the woman alone is expected to, you know, shave her legs, you know, shave her vagina, you know, to look, to be fresh and appealing. What about the man? What are we saying about the men? What are we saying about the men? I know my men are very aware. When I say, and let me say again, when I say my men, I mean the men that come to the salon, that comes to the spa. They're very aware. It's something that they do. They've been doing for a long time. And clearly it works for them, because they keep on doing it. But then I've gone out and I've seen, I mean, have you ever gone to, like, say, for example, the perfect place I've always gone to and just scan the place is like all boys champs, where you have our football game. And you just scan, because that's what I do. It's my business, my field. But you scan the entire place and you say to yourself, seriously? Like, you know what I'm saying? So those men, yes, norm, keep clean, and any minute with no notice, our head in your lap, and absolutely, because you're ever fresh, because I'm ready like Tevin Campbell, absolutely. Mr. Johnson, but you see, you got that long time. You know what I'd like to ask you, O'Neill? How did you get it? Since certain people are saying it's not the norm, how did you get it? And when, at what age did you get it? Was it your father? Was it another male, somebody that showed you what to do? Was it your mother? Was it your brother? Let us know why is it, how did you get that memo that you must be clean and fresh all the time? Does Jan have kids? If so, how different or difficult was it to keep up appearance while at home? Jan, you got that question? It should be, but this is the first time we have spent so much time together. Yes, and that's what I'm saying. Now is the time to have that conversation. I mean, as I said, just like the computer, everything needs to be updated. I may not like what I liked when I was 25. Actually, I don't. My tastes have changed. What I need is different. Started with an older girl I had a crush on. So she taught you that you needed to be groomed. And you saw the results from being groomed. I can bet. Did you have time back then? Oh, you mean you're talking about when Jan, you see some questions there posed for you? Yes, I do. I have. She has three grown kids. But Jan, I can tell you, I've known Jan for quite a number of years now, and Jan is always well put together. And I'm sure any man would appreciate that. So it's not a mistake why she's there for 35 years. I would shower, brush my teeth, comb my hair, and go over. So, O'Neill, what I'd like to ask you then, so when you see your brothers, I'm going to say your brothers, the other males, just not taking care of themselves, they come to the gym, you can smell them from a mile, or they have a whole heap of bush underneath their arm, you go into the shop, they don't take care of their bodies. Especially, one of the weak areas I find is teeth. I know there's a fear of the dentist. I know that there's a definite, my 25 years experience, I can definitely tell you that I can see that there is a definite fear of going to the dentist. So you'll find that some men, they're behind us in the oral hygiene department. And this is something that, you know, you really need to step up on. We were always at work, working long hours. Yeah. But you never lost sight, which is important. You never lost sight, meaning still maintaining your attraction. Because some people take it for granted that because you're a wife or because you're a husband, I must be attracted to you, or I must still want to sleep with you. And that's not so. It became a part of you. And that's excellent, because you are, I mean, you're exceptional. I mean, very few men are like you, to be honest. But it is appreciated, just to let you know. The ones I talk to closely, I would give a gentle nudge. And the others I ignore, because that's a touchy topic. Yeah, but why would you, can anybody explain to me, any woman out there explain to me why they would have a man at home who is unkempt, who requires sex, who they have to have sex with, and they wouldn't say to them? I'm not getting that. I'm trying to understand. And that's why we're having a conversation, because maybe someone out there can enlighten the woman who would like it as to how best they can segue into the conversation. Is it to have a shower together, to bring the topic? And I know some men are very touchy as to, why you want me to do this now? So who you see this with, or who you, which one of your girlfriend have you talked about this now? I know men can be very challenging at times. How did they get there in the first place? Did they drop the ball? Did they drop the ball, or did the parents drop the ball? Because that's a biggie. Because whereas the some parents spend the time to make sure you wash your ears, wash behind your ears, because that's a big one. Behind the ears, they forget it. And I'm talking now from my personal experience. Wash behind the ears, right? Where they spend a lot of time on the girls and say, oh, you must do this, you must shave your legs, you must shave your armpit. Men don't know that. I mean, if your arm is extremely bushy, you can trim down the hair and it can still be masculine. You don't have to shave, right? So sometimes the parents drop the ball. But then as adults, we read, we are exposed, right? Keep my little music in the background going to keep the company, right? We are exposed. I mean, some don't read, and that's a problem. Some men don't care, or they weren't trained to pay attention to personhood. And I don't blame the men. If it is accepted, let me explain something to you, ladies. If men are still getting sex, they will not change. If it is not a requirement, they will not change. Men do what women want. The environment you grew up in play a significant part in how men are cultured. Absolutely. But then we cannot continue to say that because we grow up. And it's not like in our dark ages when we had to look in an encyclopedia to get information. No, everything is in the palm of your hand. It's a click away. Plus, women are very educated these days. They are exposed. They are independent. They know what they want. But somehow, they're still not having some. Let me clarify. When I'm not broad brushing, I'm just saying based on my experience, married, unmarried, are still turning up unkempt. Why is that? Let us have that discussion. Why is that? Is it a lack of interest? But even if the interest is not at home, I know they're not going without sex. So somebody is having sex with them. And the same goes for women. Come on, Nats, talk up a thing. Old habits are hard to die. I don't think so. Because if I have a requirement and it's not being met, then it's a no-go item. I don't see where it's difficult. Why is it difficult? Some men don't care. But if the man, as I said before, and men tend to think spending money on grooming is not so important. They give women the money and in turn expect the sex. I totally agree with you. Totally agree with you. And that is why I said it should be a requirement. Some men will never change no matter what you do or say. Well, if you want to continue to have sex with a man that's smelly, unkempt, peace, more power to you. I just don't understand. Because I cannot, Sandro, bow to stop. You know me, Adrian. I'm for the betterment of my men, and I'm for progress, and I'm for updating, and I'm for, remember, you know, I'm a 56-year-old woman, and I'm having these conversations with other women, and we are also, you know, experiencing men who don't see it important. We're not talking about boys. We're talking about big men, generally speaking. Because money runs, Sandy. Some folks have to run. Really? Really? No. Money cannot replace a sexual, passionate experience. Well, that is my opinion. Right? Yes. But that is a straight exchange. What, money for sex? Is that what you're saying? There's no requirement on a woman's part? Really? So why does a woman then bother to go? Well, I suppose you're going to say, well, she goes to the hairdresser and she does her nails because she wants to get the money. Is that what you're saying? Because if I am going to have sex with you, being clean should be a requirement. After a recent visit for services and discussing the prelude of this session, I asked my partner how does the way I take care of myself makes her feel and contributes to our relationship. What did she say? But whether or not a woman can also take care, but whether or not a woman can also take care of her man too. Yes, Anika, but that is one if she has the time. COVID is just a period, you know. We're talking about in general, you know. COVID is just an opportunity to open the door, to have a discussion, to start the experience. And then, you know, he takes it from there. He wash my back, I wash his. Excellent. Yes, that's where you start. Her response was good, positive, a plus, and makes her feel safer. Now, these are some of the feedbacks that I want to hear. That's awesome. And the thing is, it means that, you know, you're taking care of yourself for her, just like how she's taking care of herself for you, which should be standard. Why am I going? I mean, apart from my personal pride now, and my self-esteem and looking good and I want to be attractive to the general public. Oh no, I'm talking about the money part. No, I'm not getting that about the money part. Oh, what is the topic? The topic is maintaining your sex appeal during COVID-19. You're in the house, locked down. Do you wear the same nightie the 7 days? Do you wear the same boxers for 5 days, 6 days, 7 days? Don't change it because you don't really care. Because whether or not you're going to get sex anyway, you know, do you bother to put on like a cologne? Do you bother to shave your pubic area? Do you bother to make yourself attractive for those persons who want to have oral sex? Do you make sure that you are oral sexable? I'm saying. Or do you have to wade through the bush to have the experience? I care of myself for me still. Yes, Anil, but your wife benefits. Some of us want it anywhere, anytime, and we have to facilitate that by taking. Absolutely. My motto is from head to toe. The word I would use, I would not use it on this forum, but from head, from the tip of your strand to your toenail should be, let me be gentle, love worthy. So I shouldn't go down to your toe and have to draw breaks. I shouldn't go to your pubic area and have to draw breaks. Right? That's what I'm talking about. Because it don't smell fresh. And it's not appealing. Means he gives me money to take care of myself. I take him to get pampered. That works too. But we were talking specifically about, you know, now that you're in COVID lockdown, persons can't get out. Would you take the opportunity, just like how you, let's say you cook and feed each other, taking care of yourself, boost your self-esteem, because I think some men have the issue not confident in themselves. True, you have to. It make it more attractive. Absolutely. But what I'm saying is I'm still seeing persons who don't care. And they have wife, they have girlfriend, or they have man, or they have whatever. You wanted to say suckworthy. It rhymes. It rhymes with that. I'm just saying, from head to toe should be clean. Girl, I'm so locked down, I need a waxing like yesterday, but I do tidy up and trim, although I don't live or have a man, but I do it for me. Absolutely. But Shireen, okay. What we're also saying is that why are women accepting men unkempt? That was one of the arguments we were having. Women generally, for the most part, let us say if we were going to go percentages, let us say 80% of women take care of themselves. 80% of women take care of themselves. What would the percentage be with men? And men have many women. How do you explain that? Can't be money. I refuse to accept that money replaces that need for cleanliness, that need for sex appeal, that need for attractiveness. Yeah, 35%. You're more there. Right? How do we explain that? And why in 2020 are we still accepting that? I don't understand. Some don't care. They only want the money. Some men think grooming is being soft. They think women want a rough, bad man. Being a bad man and being rough don't necessarily mean you're unkempt. There are two different things. Two different things. I've heard people say man have for rough, man hand for rough. Who told a man that? Because it's coming from a man. Who told him that? A woman? I doubt that very much. And men have different jobs. Some work around a desk. Some work in the field. Some work under a truck. Right? They have different types of jobs. But the bottom line is, your hands are still used for lovemaking. And what are you going to do? Insert dirty nails where? The nails still have to be clean. The nails still, and all nails, all 10, right? Need to be clean. Because if you are interested in pleasing your woman, any at all, then your hands need to be ready for the job. If you have a woman, she could be or could have, no sir, even if we are going to die tomorrow, a man as well groomed until him dead. But we are talking about the men that are more aware. Yes, money play a part. No self-value. That is true. But how can we start that conversation? To be honest, there is still a stigma where men getting groomed is associated with being metro or gay. Unfortunately, and I'm no longer going to buy that O'Neill. You know why? Because it's 2020. Everybody is on social media. Everybody is aware. It's no longer, you don't have to go in a book anymore to read it. Everybody is aware of what is required. But as I said before, we first have to address the stigma. Well, there's no stigma totally male. I can promise you that. And a lot of my clients are very macho and holding down their jobs and very important positions and are very masculine, but they are into keeping themselves clean. Educate the people. Take care of yourselves. Thank you. Even the so-called bad boys are getting groomed. Absolutely. Absolutely. But what the challenge is when your significant other drops the ball. Because it's all well and good you didn't learn growing up, right? Or it's all well and good you weren't socialized that way. But when you get to an adult and you're exposed, use exposure. It doesn't make sense to just, this is right. I'm still not getting the lack of grooming. I'm not getting it. True man for cleanup. Absolutely. What about, do you think men take the time out to look at what they're putting on in the household, or they just drawn a tear up t-shirt. Thank you. Drawn a tear up t-shirt and not bother to even try to look attractive to his woman. How about that? Can anybody address that? Body waxing can be painful. How do you convince a male to shave his back, especially? Well, body waxing is painful, and so that's why you can shave, not necessarily with a razor. You can shave with the fading machine, which doesn't take it down too low to skin, but low enough for you not to be having a lot of perspiration, and it takes off the heavy hair. You don't have to be clean. You don't have to be hairless, but at least debulk, so that you don't have to be perspiring all the time. The modern times men must step up them grooming, just as all they want certain look and hygiene from women. Absolutely. But again, I say, and I will continue to repeat, a woman has to require it. A woman has to require it. And it's the same thing with the man. If the man don't require it from the woman, or the woman don't require it from the man, then that's where Joe Grind and I don't know what the lady name. What's her name again? You have Side Chick.